Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. It's your brother Yahya Ibrahim with another daily tafsir, alhamdulillah. We are doing a surah a day, alhamdulillah, and we're beginning with Juz Amma. Inshallah, the aim is that we can give a 5-minute description of every surah of the Quran. Surah Amma Yatasa'aloon, or Surah An-Naba, the great news, the prophecies that are to come, is surah number 78 in its tartib, in its placement in the Quran. Surah An-Naba was revealed to the Prophet ﷺ in his early years in Mecca. It's from the earlier revelations. We know this from the sound of the surah, the rhythm of the surah, the shortness of its verses, and the profoundness of its message. The message of surahs that were revealed in Mecca al-Mukarramah to the Prophet ﷺ revolve around three main themes. One, the oneness and unity of Allah, Tawheed. Number two, establishing the messengership or the risala of the Prophet ﷺ. And number three, is that there is ba'ath and nishur, and there is an akhirah. There is a place where you will be questioned by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that this worldly life, there is more to it than just the life that you live. Surah An-Naba is a very important surah. It has clear sections in it. The first section of the surah is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala refutes the concept of those who doubt that there will be a day of reckoning and a day of judgment. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, why is there this astonishment? عَمَّ يَتَسَأَلُونَ. What is it that they're debating about? عَنِ النَّبَإِ الْعَظِيمِ. And this is one of the great features of surahs that are revealed in Mecca in the early revelation. There are surahs that have a cliffhanger effect. عَمَّ يَتَسَأَلُونَ. What are they debating about? So you say, well, I don't know. عَنِ النَّبَإِ الْعَظِيمِ. About the great news. Well, what is it? الَّذِي هُمْ فِيهِ يَخْتَلِفُونَ. They remain in it disputing. Well, what is it? So every ayah wants you to learn more and to sit and listen to more of what is being recited. And this was one of the ways that Allah allowed people to hear the Qur'an even though others would not want them to hear it. It was a way of them becoming more curious about the revelation. So the first is a refutation of the doubts that people had about the Day of Judgment. Second, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala begins to speak about his power and his authority to create. And if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rationally and logically is the one who is created, and this was something that the Arabs at the time, they understood that there is a creator. Human history has always had this belief and understanding that nothing can produce nothing. There has to be something that brings out of nothingness something. And therefore there is an intelligent design into the world, into that which we see and observe and see in the cosmos, and beyond us, and most importantly, within us. The great Imams Ali radiallahu anhu arda, the great companion of the Prophet ﷺ, he says, you marvel at the stars and the cosmos around you, but all of it is recreated within you, subhanAllah. The amount of billions of stars, you could see it in the amount of billions of cells that grow and generate and degenerate in your body each and every day. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he speaks about himself as being the creator, and therefore the one who is created surely can bring back another creation and can bring back its resurrection. Why do you doubt this? Allah then transitions to speak about the description of the Day of Judgment, and that this will be a day of severity, a day of difficulty for those who have not prepared for their day of standing before their maker, the Almighty Allah. And then Allah speaks about the punishment that will be set in store for those who have lived a wicked life, a life of excess and a life of despising other people in humanity. Third, Allah transitions to speaking about reward and about the people who have lived a life of constancy and patience and love and devotion, fidelity to others, kindness to others, even to their enemies. Allah speaks about them, that they will be the people who will be rewarded. And finally, Allah speaks about the state of the people on the Day of Judgment. لا يتكلمون. There won't be the ability to just speak freely and do whatever you want. Those days of you deciding for yourself what I want, what I don't want, come to an end. You are now in the court of the Almighty Allah. So Allah speaks about those general six themes in a very intricate way. They all funnel back to the three main reasons of revelation, the early revelations to the Prophet ﷺ, to establish Tawheed. There's only one Allah, and it's only He who deserves your service and worship. Leave off these idols, leave off these false deities, leave off these pagan traditions. Number two, the Messenger ﷺ, the risala that is delivered to him is a truth, and this is evidence of it. And third and finally, prepare for your akhirah. What are some of the signs of Allah as being the creator, the sustainer, the one who will bring resurrection, he speaks about al-ard mahda, I've made the earth as a flooring for you to live on. Wal-jibala awtada, the mountains pegged and give a solidity to it. The creation of man and the creation of things, khalaqnakum azwaja, there's a male and a female, there's a positive and a negative, and everything in life has these polar opposites that Allah, and this was something, this is revolutionary, this wasn't something science had come to an understanding of. Allah speaks about the alternation of sleep and wakefulness, the night and the day, the skies and the heavens. Allah speaks about the sun and dryness and the rain and the gardens that they produce. All of them are given in contrast to one another, in juxtaposed to one another, about the ability of Allah to bring into action what others are unable to. And then Allah speaks about the Day of Judgment. He speaks about the heralding of the Day of Judgment, the announcement of it, and nufiqa fissur, and the trumpet, and the forming of groups. You will be put together with those who are like in behavior and attitude and belief, that there will be an opening on the Day of Judgment to the sky. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَجِيءَ يَوْمَئِذٍ بِجَهَنَّمٍ. In other places, Allah speaks about, you know, hellfire will be brought forward, and that there will be a long time period, that the judgment isn't just something instantaneous, it's a period of difficulty. The people in Jannah will be given the luxuries of happiness and contentment. And those who are God-fearing will be with Allah in Jannah with grapes and happiness and gardens of delight, and all of these things will be blessed to them. While those who were vile in their speech, opposite to pure speech, will have regret, and they will say, we wish that we had another chance at life. Surah An-Naba is a profound surah if you deliberate on it. This was the 78th chapter of the Quran with your brother Yahya Ibrahim as a part of our daily Tafseer series, which you can find on my YouTube channel and other social media. And it is something that I do invite you to share with others if you feel its value, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. And it is a surah a day from the very last juz of the Quran. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.